Some mathematics, you're any good at that. But don't worry if you ain't, just look like you are, it helps. Now, the Board of Admiralty, they decreed that you needed a piece of rope long enough to anchor a ship in 40 fathoms of water. And to do that, the rope's got to be 3 times that long. That makes it 120 fathoms. A quarter of a mile is well over 1,000 foot. In fact, the rope walk where all this goes on is 1,140 foot long. And this is why. To make a piece of rope is all about twisting yarns together. Well, you'd call it string, we call them yarns. And if you've ever held a piece of string in both hands and twisted it, do you know what happens to it? It does. It gets shorter, but it gets tighter at the same time. And makes ropes is all about twisting yarns together, what gets shorter and tighter. This is how it's done. They take as many yarns as they need for the size of the rope that they want in circumference. Now it could be that big, it could be that big, or it could be that big. And all of the yarns start 1,000 foot long every month. They put the yarns together and they start spinning them. Now it ain't all done at once, as you can see. It's done in sections, but I'll come back to that. Now once you've got all that spinning done together, what started as 1,000 foot yarns ends up as a piece of rope 720 foot long, because they reduced down, see? 720 foot, 120 fathoms. Don't you know how many feet there is to a fathom then? Thank you. 6 foot to 1 fathom. 120 fathoms, 720 foot. Oh, it's going to be an uphill one. Prisons, that's right. So you've got prisoners and kidnapped men running the guns. So how does he do it? Well, I'll tell you. Down to two things. The first thing is to train him. Those men were trained and trained again. And trained some more after that. Oh, the training was rigorous and severe. And the other side of it, of course, I find not many people heard of, not these days anyway, is a little thing called discipline. Yeah. Cool. The discipline was severe all right here. Do you know what that discipline would mean? Rope, that's right, rope. Another good use. But what did they make with it? Yeah. Now, I'm surprised you know that, see? Because there is a picture of one up here, and I would have called it a whip. It's a whip, isn't it? Unless you're in the Navy. So the question here is, how's it get called the cat and nine tails? Why not a dog of three tails? Hmm? Why the cat and nine tails? It has got nine tails, well observed, madam. It has got nine tails. In fact, you can't make a rope with less than 9 yards. But why a cat? Why not a giraffe?
Cat and nine tails.
No, everybody says that, sir, and it's totally wrong. Nice try. Anybody else know? Now that you want to, don't you now? Yeah. Oh, I'm going to tell you. If you ever see a man what's been flogged, you don't see many of them these days, and it's a bit in my opinion, however, find yourself a man what's been flogged, look at his back. It looks like a great big cat has scratched deep marks across his back. That's how it got the name of the cat. And now I'm going to tell you how it happened. Because in Nelson's time, it weren't a matter of if, it was when the man got flogged, because they all got flogged. They don't have to be standing there with their hands in their pockets, looking lazy. They'd be flogged. And a man to be flogged would be taken away, thrown in a prison on board the ship, that's known as the brig. in with him, they were throwing a piece of rope. To sit there and make his own cat and nine tails to be flogged with. Now, once it was made, and he'd have to make a good job, of course, it was taken from him, given to the bosun, who would put it in a calico bag, but tie it to the mast, and it would stay there until the flogging was about to take place. Everybody knew when it was going to happen, you know how? Yeah, somebody would let a cat out of bag, of course. Yeah? See, it's simple when you know, isn't it? Yeah, you got all of those, yeah. All of those. I could go on forever with those. However, the man would be brought up to the top deck, but between that man making the cat and him being flogged, things would happen to the tails, like knots would be put in the tails. And I'll tell you why. When that rained down on that man's back, those knots didn't just take the skin off his back, it ripped the flesh out down to the bones. So the man would be brought up to the top deck in front of the old ship's company, would be flogged. Once the punishment was over, the ship's doctor would go over with a bucket of water, pour it on the man's back, washing away all that flesh that's been ripped out, all that skin that's going to be hanging down, and all that blood will be gushing out so he can see where the wounds were. To treat that man, the doctor would rub salt into his wounds. And that was part of the punishment. That was to try and stop the infection setting in. Then the man would be taken away and dealt with accordingly. Hopefully he'd recover, because you know what happened to him if he died? And a lot of them did. He would be sewn up in his hammock, last stitch through the nose. You know what I did that, don't you?
Sure, it was a good
one. Yeah, yeah. If you ever put a needle through your nose, it'll bring a tear to your eye, for sure. Yeah. And then he'd be over the side. That's right. Do you know why the flogging was done on the top deck of the ship? It weren't just the entertainment value. No, there's another reason. Conditions on board were so cramped it weren't enough for him to swing a cat anywhere else. Guess. Go on, just guess. Multitasking.
Maybe doing something up there or something here.
That means two, does it?
Yes.
Wrong, it wrong, Arthur. Big mistake. Multi means many, two is two. Now you've got to put Now, sir, come over this side. You're going to do multitasking. I'm going to give you three tasks to do. I don't want to overdo it or wrong. Now, the first task, Arthur, is to turn this handle by pulling it towards your knees, up to your nose, and over. The second task is to work with that gentleman down there as part of a team. That means you have to turn the handle the same speed that he does.
How quick do
you want to do it? Yeah, you go as fast as you like. Now the third task, Arthur, is this is called a traveller. It's got wheels on it. It means it's going to be moving.
Right.
Now, the thing is, Arthur, which way is it going to go? Because you need to know that.
Oh, well. Yeah, it's still spinning and probably go that way.
It will indeed, because when you turn the handles, Arthur, you're going to spin these hooks, what's going to twist these 9 yards.
Right.
When you do that twisting, it gets shorter, doesn't it?
Yes.
So you've got two little sides to do it at the same time.
Yes.
Good. Okay, come this way, please. Your name?
Jean.
Jean. I have a cough. Well, good job for you, Jean. You don't have this piece of rope. Yeah, I'm as simple as it sounds, I Jean. I'll tell you why. Now, Jean, you are the guide. What means you have to keep that traveller in a straight line when Arthur turns that handle? The thing is, as you know, it's going to move. So here's the thing. Don't play tug of war, because if you pull this rope when they're turning the handle, you will break the rope they're making and you've got the rope. Okay. But, Gene, if you let this rope go loose and that goes over there and kills anybody, guess who gets the rope? No, it's that shit. Well, if you turn that hard enough and it goes over there, she ain't holding that bit of rope to stop it going over. It's going to kill anybody over there, isn't it? I don't know. Did you want to choose somebody?
As long as it wasn't.
Okay, right. We'll turn as you're ready to go, sir. Right. Pull our handles towards your back. Faster, I'll go on much faster than that. Give you a sweet thing. Thank you.
charged at 1,840 brake horsepower each. They're powering two generators and they use the charging battery cells up. Now to do that, you come up near the surface, you raise the search lights.
It's a lift.